Welcome, my friends, to another Cheap Meal Monday. And today, you find me in my pantry because we're going to use some of my pantry items to make today's Cheap Meal Monday. So stay tuned. You can see my pantry is a mess. I got rid of my big freezer that was sitting right here in front of me. And I'm going to really organize my pantry, but I have to wait just a few more weeks until my son moves out because some of this pantry stuff is going into another room. But for today's Cheat Meal Monday, we are going to get some canned chicken, and we're going to make some barbecue chicken, and we're going to look and see what's inside my dry goods bin and see if we can use something up that's been in there for quite a long time. So, the first thing I want to do is, and I'm going to show you the mess because this is my life and these are areas I have to work on. But I have all kinds of jars that I really don't have any place to go with them. These are things I just canned this week. But what I wanted to show you was, once I get things really organized, I'm going to organize everything by date. Right now, the dates are written on the top of each jar. But so, this says 2015 on this chicken, but if I go way back, I was thinking I have older chicken, but it is all 2015, so that's really great. I thought some of it was older than that. So, what we're going to do is I'm going to get about maybe 5 of these pints, and we're going to make Crock-Pot barbecue shredded chicken with it because we have to use it up. So there's 3, and there's 4, and let me go back here and get another one, and that's 5. So we're going to take these and let's go into the kitchen and let's make some barbecue chicken. So what I used was 5 pounds of shredded chicken that was canned, and this was canned in 2015, so it's about time to get it used up. I have a very old crock pot that really works well, and we're going to just dump all the chicken into the crock pot. Now remember, this is shredded, deboned chicken. It's mixed with white meat and with dark meat. The whole idea of this meal is it's going to be in the crock pot for a couple hours. When you're making any kind of barbecue, it's really good to have it on low, but have it for quite a few hours so all of the flavors can simmer together. Now, I am the kind of person who doesn't follow any recipe in order. So, what I'm going to do is we're going to dump some ketchup in it. There's really no measurements to this. And what I do is I always put like a tablespoon or two of prepared mustard in it. And then we're going to just have a little bit of brown sugar. And we're going to mix that all together. And it's going to simmer for quite a few hours. Now, if you have frozen shredded chicken, you can do it that way too. But we're going to put the lid on it and we're going to let it simmer for a few hours. And while the lid is on it, I'm going to cut up one onion and we're going to put one onion in as well. What you want to keep in mind is when you're open any kind of canned goods, is make sure you hear the lid pop. So you want to make sure there was a really good seal before you eat the food. If in doubt, my grandma always said, when in doubt, throw it out. So you want to always make sure that when you open a jar that you hear that popping sound, that you hear that there was a good seal. Because especially with meats, you don't want to get botulism. But if your jar is really good and sealed, that will not happen and you pressure can your foods. Always make sure you pressure can your low acid vegetables and pressure can your meat. So I'm just cutting up this onion. This is going to simmer in this crock pot for at least 5 hours. And that's what really makes it good. So we have the onions, everything is in, and everything's all ready to go. And now we're just going to wait. So now I'm going to show you what we're going to eat for the side of our chicken pork barbecue. Now I'm going to show you what we're going to eat for the side of our chicken barbecue. So, in my freezer, I still have some corn that a friend gave me 2 years ago. And this corn is actually very tasty. It's very good. So what we're going to do is we are going to have corn. Put in this one. So I'm putting it out now so it can thaw out, so that way it's ready to heat up because it's still frozen. So corn is going to be our one side, and then I have one of these rice packets that I'm really trying to use up. So the rice packets is going to be on the other side. And I generally do not have a dessert at every meal. So we have a lot of fresh fruit right now, and so we have watermelon, and we have cantaloupe, and we have apples. So we're going to have fresh fruit as our dessert. So there you go, my friends. The chicken barbecue is in the crock pot, and I have the corn thawing out, and then I have the rice. So then I can get started on a big project today, and that is canning bacon baked beans. So get ready, because we're going to have a video coming up of me making baked beans. Take care, everyone, and we'll see you guys tomorrow. And when it's all done, I'll plate everything up, and I'll show you what the plate looks like. Well, my friends, because this is the end of my zero spending month, I still have to use up all the things that I have. So I'm going to show you how I plate it up. So this is the barbecue chicken, and it really is delicious. So I toasted some bread because I did not have any rolls and I didn't have time to make any. You can either put a tomato on top or you can have it on the side. I'm going to have mine on the side. So we're going to put the lid on it. Barbecue chicken sandwich with a spoon of corn with one of my pesto tray cubes that I made the other day. One with some rice. So, we have a vegetable, a carb, and depends on who you ask, we have a fruit. Some people say that tomatoes are a vegetable, and others say they're a fruit. I say they're a vegetable. And we're going to put a little bit of my mix, spice mix, on the tomato, just like that. And there you go, my friend, is a cheap meal Monday, made with a little bit from the freezer, a little bit from that pantry, and a little bit from my canning pantry. So day by day, step by step, we're getting this food made and we're getting this food. So little by little, step by step, the food is getting made and the food is getting eaten. Little by little and step by step, I am working on my getting rid of some of the food that's been sitting in my pantry. And this is a good meal. It's very frugal and has a little bit of all the food groups. And for dessert, we're going to have some fruit. Take care, everyone, and we'll see you tomorrow. Hi, my friends. If you liked this last video, can you do me a favor? Can you share it or like it or make sure you're subscribed? By sharing and liking my video, it helps get my video out into the world, and YouTube recognizes that video, and I will get more views. Thanks again so much for watching, and we'll see you tomorrow. Bye!